And so therefore, I am proud and delighted to welcome you all here to see. I'm delighted to welcome our staff, to welcome the local clergy, to welcome our parents, board of management, and most of all, to welcome our students, our graduating sixth-year class of 2022. Every year, talking to people in schools, and honestly, I would hear horror stories about 6 years going on the rampage. I'd hear about doors being taken off hinges. I'd hear about, and not that I'm trying to give you ideas, I'm hearing about this kind of big, I don't know where you get, I don't want to know, big industrial type, cling film type things that are put around teachers' cars. You're hearing about all sorts, and stuff that would really make your hair stand on end. Metaphorically. And I have to say, our students conducted themselves with great dignity, with humour, with pleasure, but with absolute dignity and respect. You know, and so much so that I know out in the quad yesterday when we were having our little farewell, there were tears from staff and from students. Can I just say to the parents, that most of whom I've worked with you over the last 5 to 6 years, then there'd be a certain number maybe where the students joined us in TY or joined us in fifth year. And last Monday night, we had our meeting for the parents of the incoming first year students. So we have 270 students starting in September. And what struck me and what I really liked about last Monday night's meeting was that there are a number of parents here tonight who were also here on Monday. Now, I don't think they just managed to sneak in. I think they were there because they genuinely had a child starting their first year in September. And I just think there's something really nice about that. You know, there's a journey with one student ending tonight and then they're beginning again. And there's that lovely sense of continuity and they're there ready to begin. So I think there's something really nice. But I want to just thank the parents for their support over the last 6 years. And I know, and it would be impossible to say otherwise, of course we didn't agree on everything. We didn't always agree, but we always did come to an understanding. And I certainly always appreciated and recognised when I was talking to a parent that they were coming down on the side of their child, which is appropriate, and that they were supporting their child. And ultimately, we always came to some sort of understanding. To the parents, I would say to you, you can be justifiably proud of your sons and daughters who have grown in their time here from shy, hesitant, reluctant, anxious first years to the upstanding, mature, confident adults you see in front of you this evening. You can be rightly proud of them. And I think a round of applause for our students. And the support staff who've been working with your sons and daughters met you. And at that stage, you, like your sons and daughters, were also a little bit worried. I always say to parents when we have that incoming meeting for the parents of incoming first years, that while a lot of our first years are usually a bit anxious about starting in secondary school, usually for the first time parents, it's a little bit traumatic as well, and a little bit difficult too. So I feel that the parents have also had that journey. And I hope, like your sons and daughters, you were kind of unsure.
Yeah, it may as well sit down with this.
But while you were unsure, obviously, about how things were going to go, I really do hope that you were happy ultimately with your choice in the school. It's probably a little bit late now if you were telling me, but still. That leads me on to the Parents Association as well. I'm very conscious that a core part of the Parents Association are leaving this year. They're finishing up. Their youngest child has, you know, is just completing, is graduating tonight. And there's a certain core group who've really worked so hard and really support so many different school events and initiatives. You know, and a lot of that is in the background. Some of it's very apparent. Like tonight now, for example, when we're finished here, the Parents Association, as is their custom, will be providing recipient every freshman for everybody. And you know, a bit of planning and a bit of time and effort and money goes into that. The parents do it every year. But behind the scenes, the parents also support so many different school activities and initiatives. And I just want to say a big thank you to the Parents Association. And I'm conscious as well, and I've seen a number of the names of people who are coming on board tonight, because the people who would normally be serving the teas and the refreshments are actually in here tonight. And there are new parents coming on board, which I think is great and really, really helping. And these parents have just given so generously of their time, their commitment and their support to Gorey Community School, and that's absolutely lovely. I'm always reluctant, and I do this to staff as well, I'm always reluctant to try and pick out one person, which means I am going to pick out one person. But I think in this case, it's particularly important. There's one member of the Parents Association who unfortunately, and she is at absolutely everything in the school, she's a huge supporter and loyal parent of Gorey Community School for so many years, and you know, she's had so many different roles, a very active role in the Parents Association, a very active role on the Board of Management, but is just there and turns up and organises absolutely everything. If there's anything going on, any kind of initiative, and I really need to get in contact with a parent, or if members of staff are organising something, or members of the Board of Management are organising something, the go-to person for so many years now, certainly for the 13 years that I'm in the job, but prior to that, Trish Crowe was on. Trish was working in the school many years ago before she became a member of the Parents Association, and Trish was working on the school completion programme, and I was a year ahead at the time, and I would have had a lot of interactions with Trish then. Trish, as I said, very active member of the Parents Association, very active member of the Board of Management here and in Bone School Loretto, and just a very solid and loyal parent, and we're certainly very appreciative of all the work Trish has done. And this Trish was most unfortunate that just Trish, due to a prior very important family engagement, Trish was unable to attend tonight. So I'm going to ask Anya, who's I'd say is going to be absolutely mortified, to come forward and accept a gift on behalf of Trish from the Parents Association. This week is such an unusual one because on the one hand, there's an element of celebration. It's our awards week. Students are looking forward to their graduation, they're looking forward to going out afterwards, they're looking forward to family coming around, they're saying goodbye to teachers, they're getting their yearbooks, you know, and it's a lovely, positive, exciting time. And then, on the other hand as well, there's also an element of sadness, because I know that all of you are fond of Gorey Community School, and that you will carry lovely memories of the school with you, and I know you've enjoyed. Okay, there's been challenges, but then that's life, but you've enjoyed coming to school, and you've enjoyed, and certainly from hearing the sounds and the laughter whenever you're all assembled, or when you're socialising in the quad, or before school, or after school, or the break, it's very clear that you're happy in school for the most part. So I know there's a sense of sadness because you're kind of missing all of that, and you're kind of saying goodbye to your friends. And it's all appropriate, because there's a lovely sense of excitement as well, because you're getting ready for your next stage. I just felt that your fondness for the school was so much in evidence in the quad yesterday. We were lucky with the weather. Once again, the Parents Association had provided some refreshments. You were getting your yearbooks. And what really struck me was you came down, you were brought down to the quad 10 minutes before the bell went, about 5 to 3. And yet, by 4:30, there were still crowds of you there. It wasn't a case of, okay, I'm grabbing the bone and the yearbook and the water and I'm going off to do something better. You were there talking to your teachers, talking to each other. The atmosphere in the quad was absolutely lovely, and it was really, really nice. And it was emotional. I said this earlier. There were teachers who were upset. There were students who were upset, and there's something lovely. And it speaks volumes about the impact, what you have brought to Gorey Community School, and what you've gained from the school. And really what, you know, my wish for you is that you continue and to go forward after leaving CERT and just embrace the many wonderful opportunities that life has to offer you. I'm not normally a man for quotes, but I am going to give you one quote tonight, and it's from this African-American writer, Maya Angelou. Now, I have to admit, it's not somebody or it's not something I would have been normally reading. The only reason I came across her is that in a former life, when I was teaching English to A-level students, it was one of the books on the course, and that's why I kind of know about it. But I thought it was very interesting. It's not necessarily something that you will agree with, or necessarily agree with or disagree with, but I just think the quote is an interesting one. And she said, "People will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel." And I really hope that in Gorey Community School, we made you feel safe. I hope we made you feel cherished. And above all, I really hope we made you feel valued. And I hope that you keep all of the positive memories of Gorey Community School somewhere deep inside you. Thank you very much. I just wanted to say a couple of words of thanks as well. I know Miss Redmond, our chaplain, has been galloping around the place, really working hard, trying to organise it, and a huge amount of time and organisation. I know Miss Redmond had a lot of support from the music department, from the RE department, from the caretaking and cleaning department. So it's a kind of a joint effort, and it was led certainly by Miss Redmond. And it's a lovely event. Miss Redmond was organising to be live streamed and organising, you know, the various people to come along and putting everything together and just coordinating with people. So it's a lovely event, Mary. It's really special. It's really important, and I want to thank you for organising it.
Welcome to give of what will be. Above all, we acknowledge God's presence in ourselves, each other, and the world around us. Walk with us, Lord, as we move from this place into a future filled with your love and peace. Fill your children with love and peace, especially this class of 2022.
Audric is presenting a musical instrument. This represents all the musical talent of the school and the joy we have gained from music in our lives. We remember with gratitude the work that students and teachers have done together to help us celebrate all the special events in our school lives. Jack is presenting a trophy. This represents all the successes we have had in sport and cultural events during your 5 or 6 years here in Gorey Community School. It also represents the efforts made by many students that did not result in a trophy or cup, but where the students put all their effort into what they did. We acknowledge their efforts and realize that sometimes in life we do not gain a tangible reward for what we do. Colin is presenting a school tie and school journal. This tie represents the uniform of our school that we've been proud to belong to for the past 5 or 6 years. The journal represents the many rules we have followed, which have allowed us to gain great education and achieve our potential. Emily is presenting a yellow flag. Yellow is the colour of inclusion. It represents efforts we make in our school to include all people, no matter what their level of ability, ethnicity, sexual orientation, religious background, or culture. It also represents our intention to strive to make everyone feel included and valued in our school. Diana is presenting the Tree of Life. This tree has deep roots and wide branches. It represents each person's personal development, uniqueness, and individual beauty. Just as the branches of the tree strengthen and grow upwards to the sky, so too do we grow stronger, striving for greater knowledge, wisdom, and experiences as we move through life. It also represents the friendships made and the hope for the future. Ben is presenting a face mask and tablet. The face mask represents the COVID pandemic that we endured for 2 years and the efforts we made to make our way through it by caring for one another. The tablet represents the move to online teaching and learning that we had to adopt when we could not physically be in school or class. Garode is presenting a barong, which he is. which he is to great effect at the recent All-Ireland football final. It represents to us all the support and friendship that we have been lucky to have had from each other over the past 5 or 6 years. This support has seen us through the difficulties of the past 2 years and allowed us to emerge stronger and more resilient. Thank you.
Thank you.
half time. So we're going to invite our students of the year, Kelly, Aswad, and Lily to come forward.
Thank you. a great word from a great and wise woman, but in reality we are all a little bit nervous and worried about the future and what it will bring. Though this is a strange experience, it's a strange shared experience, which makes it all more exciting. We are leaving behind the security of the school we know so well, the building we know so well, the people we know so well, and even the uniform that we've been putting on every morning without a second thought will be left in our past. Some of us have plans, great plans. Some of us will flow wherever life takes us. Some of us will take the world by storm. Some of us will tread more gently. Some of us will move to foreign lands. Some of us will stay close to home. Whether we get maximum points in the leaving cert or whether we don't, we all have new paths to take, new choices and new stories to make. We are the masters of our own fate. We are the captains of our own soul. Even though we are leaving Gorey, we are leaving to go from Gorey School, let us not think of it as the end. Put it as part of a new beginning. We will take pieces of Gorey Community School with us wherever we go. All the memories, all the friendships, all the lessons learned. The way we meet the world and move through it is going to be affected by the moments we've had here. We look forward to feeling new feelings, to seize new opportunities, to dream new dreams. Let us celebrate and be glad of better lives not yet lived.
Somebody loves us all. All of us work for others, and others sacrifice for us. That is a wonderful fact. Our parents, who have sacrificed their free time to help us with our homework, spent large sums of money to get us our uniforms and books, want nothing more in return than to see us succeed. They want to see us as delightful, honourable, and dignified young men and women. More than anything else, we work for them, and they work for us, because we love each other. To all our teachers who exhaust every ounce of their free will, drafting notes, preparing PowerPoints, and correcting our straggling homework, thank you very much. We know that you do this because of your compassionate commitment to empower us. We as students do our homework, behave to the best of our ability, and strive to do well, inspired by the genuine devotion of our teachers and parents, as much as for our personal ambitions. These ambitions themselves gain greater purpose in the context of what our loved ones want. There is no nobler and more rewarding cause for action than to see joy on the faces of those we love. We spend time and share banter with our friends, console and even argue with those around us because we care and are all cared for. This is part of it. This. This is patently evident in our remarkable new group. The very fact that we are all gathered here tonight is a testimony to the respect, care and value we place on our friends and family at Gorey Community School. We may never see each other again, but reaching the ceremonious occasion together after 5 or 6 meandering adverse years is telling of how unified we are in this journey. Together as a group, the obstacles we have overcome, abstractions we have made concrete, and the sense of community that is at the essence of tonight should be cherished. This is a moving moment, a last hurrah that all of us are sharing together. Even those of us who skipped transition year or have moved from another school have grown teary-eyed. Our year group is one in which anyone can feel part of. Every one of us deserves to be here, wherever we come from, simply for who we are. What we have done and will do is a reflection of who we are. We are an accepting, honest and integrous year group, surrounded by supportive, inspirational staff and parents. Our diverse pathways have overlapped and culminated in this tremendous occasion. Let us celebrate it and the vast world of wonderful possibilities that lies ahead of us all. Thank you for listening.
about the occasion both Mia and Amy up to the stage, please. Hard to get to it, but you can do it and just keep working towards it, and you'll find the positive side of things. It is really in St. Matthew encourages us to be the light for each other.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. You are the light of the world. A city on top of the hill that can't be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a basket. Instead, they put it on a light stand. And it shines on all who are in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before the people so they can see the good things you do and praise your Father who is in heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord.
This has been an eventful 6 years with many ups and downs along the way. We've had achievements and many disappointments. We now bring our hopes and prayers to God, confident that they will be heard. I invite God, those offering the prayers, to come forward, and we begin.
Lord, as we leave this stage of our lives, may we always keep the light of hope in our hearts. With each new day that comes and every step that we take, may we always remember the true essence of the human spirit that is hope. Lord, hear us.
Tonight, Lord, we think of all the friends we have made during our years in Gorey Community School. We remember our laughter and our tears as we reach this stage of our life's journey. May you continue to be blessed with good friends. May we always carry with us good memories of the friends we have made here in this school. Lord, hear us.
Lord, tonight we remember all the places in the world where peace does not prevail, where young people like us do not have the opportunity we have to go to school in peace. We ask you to help world leaders to choose the path to peace. Lord, hear us.
There are people, Lord, who have passed away who we would have loved to share this special evening with. Our lives are better for having known them, and we are grateful for that. We pray that they may know how much they are loved and missed. Lord, keep all our loved ones here in your care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, we pray for the staff of Gorey Community School. We would like to thank them for their guidance and support throughout these memorable years. We thank you especially for the efforts that you made during COVID times to help us through and ensure that we did not miss out on school. We also pray for all the students who continue on our school. May they be happy in everything they do and always have hope in their futures. Lord, hear us.
As we reach this crossroads, may we be guided in health to choose the right road and to make the best of the gifts we've been given. Guide us to remain true to ourselves as we step tentatively into the future. Lord, hear us.
Lord, we thank you for the support of our parents throughout the years. We hope that they know how much we appreciate it. Although sometimes we might have difficulty showing up, they may know how important they are to us. Lord, hear us.
and an actor, teacher, Eleanor Hanley, parent, Colin McNamara, board of management member, Theresa Kenny, first year student, Katie Tyrrell.
Also a beginning. We've spent 6 years in this school, working and dreaming, playing sport and making friends. It's time for us to begin the next exciting phase of our lives. Although we're sad to leave this school, which has been our home and sanctuary for the past 6 years, we're excited to begin this new phase. We offer this life for ourselves and for all the other students who are in our school. Remember also at this time all the people and the places in the world where there is war. Pray that the light of hope will continue to shine for them in these troubled times.
On behalf of the school, I offer you the light of wisdom. Carry this light from this place to a world that stands in need of wisdom, a world that faces decisions and choices never dreamed of in times past. Remember that everything you learned in school was learned in the company of others. Be open to the learning that is ahead of you. May you be a light of wisdom for others. May you grow in a wisdom that will inspire you to find the good and the true. May this light of wisdom guide you during your exams and in your future life on the road ahead.
On behalf of all the parents gathered here this evening, I offer you the light of love. This is a light we lit for you a long time ago. It's the light you depended on in those early days, the light you ran to when things went wrong, the light that was left on for you because you were afraid of the dark. This is the light that waited up for you if you were late home, and the light that was always there, even though sometimes, just sometimes, you wish it wasn't. Carry this light of love into a world where real love is rare and precious. Use it to light the path of your own search to love and be loved. And when you find that the light is flickering, blown about by the troubles of life, remember that there will always be a light burning for you in that place called home.
On behalf of the trustees and management of Gorey Community School, I offer you the light of faith. Within all of us, there is a light. It is fed by joy and strengthened by faith. It sustains us through difficult times. Over the years, its flame has been fueled by the example of those around you. Now, you must carry that light for yourself. You will not find it an easy task. There may be a price to pay. The flame will flicker. It may even be extinguished for a time. But the most important thing about the flame of faith is that it is not yours alone. A lone flame cannot pierce the darkness, but many flames together can cast a great light. May you be a source of light for all you will meet on your life's journey.
On behalf of all students that you leave behind, I offer you the light of memory. When you are in sixth year, you say that the first years are very young and very, very small. But when you are in first year, as we are, you sixth year students seem very old and very big. 5 or 6 years ago seems a very long time ago. We will leave school in the year 2026. Where will you be then? Days pass by, and for you now, school days are over. Carry the light of those days with you. When you meet, tell again the stories of those years in the classroom and on the playing field. Remember the victories and the disappointments,
the lost locker key, the exam success, the sporting achievements, and perhaps the cooling off time outside the principal's office. We ask you to remember us, who will continue the story of the school to the end of 2022 and beyond. Remember us, we will remember you.
Thanks for constantly watching out for our students. for keeping us informed about students who weren't swiping in, or for trying to leave without a note. To the caretakers, the cleaners, the COVID supervisors who had a particularly tough job, especially during the last 2 years, keeping us all safe. To the SEN department, who worked tirelessly to make sure that the needs of every single child is met. A special word of thanks to the SNAs, who have been the champion for so many students over the last 6 years. You constantly go above and beyond the call of duty. To the guidance department, who have been unbelievably busy over the last year. Your work has been invaluable to the well-being of our students. We are incredibly lucky to have four fantastic guidance counsellors who are always on hand to be a sympathetic ear to those who are having a bad day, or to support you with your CEO applications, or providing information on college courses. Thank you for all the support you have given our students. To the subject teachers, who have worked so hard with our students during the past 2 years. They have worked in very difficult circumstances, especially when remote learning was once again introduced. Our subject teachers look for the potential in young people and do everything in their power to make sure that students achieve it. To the class tutors, who have developed a tremendous bond with their tutor classes over the last 2 years. And I think that that has been reflected in the numerous parties that the tutors and the students have thrown for their tutors over the last few days. You wouldn't get as many parties in Downing Street. Thank you for the huge effort and work that you have put in with your students. I know that your students are extremely grateful to all their teachers for your contribution to their learning and for the memories that they will take from your classrooms. A special word of thanks to all teachers and staff members who have given so generously of their time to train teams, to organise musicals and concerts, to organise school trips and prepare students for competitions. These extracurricular activities have greatly enhanced our students' school experiences and have given them memories which will last a lifetime. I also want to mention two people here. I mentioned about the award ceremony and I want to mention them again. To Miss O'Grady, who is your coordinator, your TY coordinator in transition year, and also to Miss O'Shea down there, who has also, in her own time and very generously, worked with a number of students. Thank you for all that you've done. To the management team, Mr. Finn, Miss Kyo, Miss McAvoy, and Mr. McCarthy, and of course our retired Deputy Principal, Mr. Duke. Thank you so much for the support that you've given to me and to the team over the past 6 years. Thank you for your excellent advice and guidance you have given to us while doing this job. Mr. Finn, thank you for your generosity of time to any issue that arose in our yearbook. You set high expectations for all in the school community, but you always show fairness, consistency, empathy and respect to everyone. To the year ahead team, Ms. Sunhoop, Ms. Moran and Mr. O'Brien, and not forgetting Mr. O'Toole, who had been your assistant year ahead up until junior cert. All of you have been a fantastic group of people to work with over the last 6 years. You genuinely care about the students and have always had their best interests at heart. You have been the most amazing support to me and to the students over the last few weeks, and I know that every student here has the greatest respect for you all. And I'm going to ask a number of students who have asked there to just present a little gift in recognition for all that you've done. I just ask them to come forward now, please. And her team, Ms. Tumulty, and And I know also that Mr. Conroy and Ms. Neary also were helping to set up the hall, which looks beautiful for tonight's ceremony. To Ms. Dempsey, Ms. Clancy, and the music department and our beautiful choirs here, who have put in so much effort in preparing tonight's ceremony and to make it as special as possible for our sixth year students. To your parents and the guardians, I wanted to say a massive thank you for the support that you have given your child and also the support that you have given to us since first year. Thanks for coming along this journey with us. You always will be the primary educators of your children. But the job of a yearhead is made so much easier when they have the backing of parents and guardians, and we can achieve little without you. For you parents, the 14 years in the school run with this child, your son or daughter, has come to an end. Your child and you have reached this major milestone. I am sure during the last few days, your thoughts drifted back to times past as you reflect on all that has been achieved, experienced and learned during what I hope were very happy school days. Remember the first day in primary school, when they tentatively let go your hand and you edged quietly and somewhat anxiously towards the door before they could see you were gone. Those primary school days when your contact details on other parents' phones were entered as Margaret, Padraig's mum. Then your child joins the local football or camogie or hurling club, and you join the endless WhatsApp groups. The stress when you've noticed you've missed 30 notifications, the relief and the annoyance when you see 30 thumbs up acknowledging receipt of message, and you make a mental note to suggest to the trainer to change the group message settings to admin only. But children grow up fast, and soon they enter the doors of Gorey Community School, and their days became filled with new subjects, new friends, going to ball, junior cert, and CAO. Sometimes children are so busy growing up, they may not notice the huge sacrifices, the enormous time and effort their parents have put into getting them to where they are today. So I ask you students to pause, spare a thought for your parents, support them like they have been there to support you. And I think they deserve a round of applause.
Life
always keep me close. Within you, all you need. As you face into the next few weeks, remember that you have the potential for great success. Dig deep, seize the opportunity, and always believe in yourselves. Now, as I said to the students at our awards ceremony on Tuesday, that we would push out our goodbyes for as long as we could. But we can only push off the inevitable for so long. Like we said, we can't freeze the picture. And so, as we bid farewell to the class of 2022, a few final words. I speak on behalf of the year his team when I say that we are immensely proud of the young people that you have become. We look proudly at the way you have matured, for the leadership that you have shown on the playing fields, to the respect that you have shown to your peers and to the staff of Gorey Community School. We are proud of those who showed up on school days when it was difficult for you to do so. We are proud of seeing you push yourself a little bit harder to get those extra points you need, or for finally having the courage to stand on stage at school concert. I can honestly say, with hand on heart, that being your near head has been the greatest privilege of my teaching career. GCS will be a little lonely for us in the near heads team next year, and we will miss your smiling faces on the corridor. But know this, the classrooms and corridors of Gorey Community School are better places for having had you in it. They say that the two best things you can give a child is roots and wings. Your parents, your home, have been the mainstay of your root system. Your parents have taught you what's right from wrong. This school too has nourished your root system. It has provided you with the knowledge and skills to problem solve, to think creatively. Your family and this school has provided you with a sense of belonging. These roots will keep you grounded and anchor you well in the weeks ahead. They will keep you strong. But remember that when a bird leaves its nest, it doesn't know it can fly until it opens its wings. Trust and have courage that your wings will open, and they will take you to wherever you need to go. We understand that the next step in your life is an important one as you sit your leaving cert exams and finalise your plans for September. But those of us here with more life experience know that there are many paths in life that can bring you happiness. And the road that you end up on is not always the road that you had chosen. Trust that it's the right one, and that it's meant for you. There are many people who will love you that you have not yet met. Your wings will bring you further afield in the months ahead. And what we ask of you is that when you get to a place or a point in your life that you're proud of, remember that we won't have forgotten you. So drop us a message. Show us how far you've grown. But our biggest hope for you is that wherever you find yourselves in life, that your wings will always be strong enough to bring you home. So thanks for the great memories. For 6 fantastic years, we wish you the very best in your exams in the weeks ahead, and we look forward to meeting up again in August. So goodbye, God bless, and thanks for the memories.
ask Father Roger Mead to give the concluding prayer on the final day.
First of all, I say that it's wonderful to be asked to be part of such a fine graduation celebration. I'm, I suppose, new to this here in Gorey, even though I'm in Gorey now a few years, but because of, you know, the COVID pandemic, we haven't been able to be part of things the way we would like to be. So this is something that's new to me. But over the years, I've been part of many such ceremonies in different places. And I must say that this is one of the finest celebrations of graduation that I've come across. In that, I was particularly taken by the theme that you've taken. Behind you, before you, around you, and within you. In that context, let me say one short thing, but very important. That in all of these aspects of life, and in the various different places and times, the high points, the low points, joys, the sorrows, the great milieu that life's journey presents to us. Remember one thing that is very important, and that is the dignity of the person who you are. I say this particularly to the young people, but in fact it's relevant to each and every one of us. Our dignity, our worth, lies precisely in the unique individual each one of us is, and also in that of the person beside you, of everyone in this room as individuals. That unique dignity comes from one single source, that is God. Because God made us who we are. Made us in his image and in his likeness. That is the unique dignity that we have. So no matter what faces us in life, be it joy, be it sorrow, be it good, be it bad, whatever it is, remember that dignity and that worth, and that will see you through. And let us pray then for God's blessing. As we end one journey and begin another, let us go forth into the world as people of faith, hope, and vision. Hold fast to that which is good, and render no one any harm. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak and the vulnerable. Help the afflicted. Give dignity and respect to all. Love and serve the Lord Jesus. Rejoice in the power and the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Bless this class of 2022. Bless their parents and guardians. We ask this, as we always do, to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you very much, and you'd be grateful to know we're coming near the end. The heat in here is a little bit overbearing. I just want to say a few final words. Trying to do all the other thanks from earlier on. But I do want to mention a couple of people, that particularly those involved here, like the musicians and the singers and the readers. And I want to just say one special word. to a little girl in first year, Katie Tyrrell, who read tonight. It's very difficult, as a lot of you found out, what they are meant to read, and I think she did wonderfully well. I think it took me a little bit. To Michael Flynn and the management team for the support of my role here in the school, to the members of the organ department, and particularly to Serena and Tommy here tonight. And I want to say no thank you to the class of 2022. Thank you for your showing your talent, your good humour, humanity, your goodness. And these qualities will stand you in good stead as you move along. And thank you for allowing me to journey with you, for allowing me into your life. It's been a privilege. I also want, they've been asking me all week, will I miss them? Well, I will miss being asked, but I will miss being missed. So I'm going to miss that. Well, yes, of course I will. I will miss you. I miss all the chats over the cup of tea and the chats in the quad and the shack and so on. And all the antics of the sporty boys in the quad and the much more mature and cooler girls next door and Alex and Gorey. The clients are Mary, I've been feeling like a celebrity all week. It's like, what is it, a cane car wash, is it? And of course, I have trained another bunch as well. And you know how long it took to train you lot in. You're the best of the best. But stay in touch. These days of social media allow us all to stay in touch. And we have a load of people here, like a part of our extended family here in Gorey Community School. I will be here for just a couple of notes. I will be here for the exams. Father Roger has he will say mass on the morning of Wednesday the 8th in the Oratory. You are also invited to take your star. Okay. Refreshments will be served in the pot, okay, outside, which you'll all be grateful for. Okay, thank you to the Parent Association for that. And finally, the year team want 6 years to stay to get your 6 year gift. You get the gift. Make good decisions. So good night and God bless.